Hello friends, welcome back. So guys, today's session we will see web services part 2. So previous demonstration just we took a one recap, like we discussed, let me open the designer. So previous demonstration what we did, we create one flow service, after that one Wsdl. Okay, so now today's demonstration what we are doing, just invoking this Wsdl in our environment, like in our flow services, and we just checking the mapping and everything. Okay, so in live project, if you receiving a Wsdl from client, so first thing you need to taking care of, like first you can check the web services document parameters, mandatory, optional, spelling, everything, and in your flow services document it should be sync. Okay, then you just invoke this URL in your SoapUI, you can just test the particular data, this Wsdl is working or not. If it is working fine, then you can invoke this Wsdl in your environment. If it is not working fine, then you can check the data issue. Yeah, you can check with the project team respective the data related issue. Yeah, whatever it may be. Okay, then today's demonstration what we're doing, we created a one Wsdl already. So we just invoking this Wsdl as a consumer. Okay, so first thing, just click on this Wsdl. This is web service, click on that, click on empty space, copy this URL, Control C, and paste it in a notepad. Okay, then consumer. And then Wsdl, click on, where so either you can use a zip file, yeah, URL. Okay, so once you click on this particular Wsdl, export option is available. So whatever location, local machine location you have, your VM location you have, you can just import, like export this URL, and after that you can import here. Okay, so now my case I have a URL, I just copy it and then click on next. Here you can select document type generation option, content model compliance, compliance, after that all those things you can just check as per your requirement, you can check. And so as of now I'm just keep as it is, and I'll click on next. After that, here you can see the assigned prefixes. Okay, if you want to change the prefix, you can change, otherwise you can keep as it is and click on finish. Now as a consumer, my web service is created, web services as a consumer. Okay, now you can see here the consumer Wsdl folder is created, and here connector, document type and responsive services is available. So as I said earlier, once you invoke the Wsdl in your environment, so first check the input document and output document. So first would be your input document, just check the parameters. Okay, this string 1, string 2 is parameter. So string 1, this is a required, it means mandatory. String 2, it's mandatory. So whenever you creating your flow service document, you need to taking care of string 1, string 2, spelling mistake, everything. And after that, required allow parameter should be your true. Okay, then check the output document as well. Here you can say the result is failed and it's a mandatory. Okay, now I'm creating one flow service, new flow service, give the name as a get consumer data. And then finish. Now I'm defining first the input output, just invoke string 1, string 2, So if you mistake any kind of a spelling mistake, yeah, mandatory, yeah, optional, you receive some signature kind of error, signature not match, okay, input signature. So to avoid such a thing, you just need to taking care of this document, optional, mandatory, then spelling mistake, camel case, lower case, upper case, everything, okay. And also, if you know your web service document having an underscore, and in your pro service document you're not using the underscore, again it should be an error. It's an input signature error, okay. Again, in output, just in open field as a result, and then save. Now here I am using like the connector, you can check, and this is a web service. You can just enoch here. This is a web service descriptor and this is a web service. Okay. So once you enoch this Wsdl like web service, then click on that. Map string 1 to string 1. Okay. Now string 2 to string 2, and here result field is available. Result is available, just map. And second thing, we also need to define the like user password. In our case, you have any other details as per Wsdl documentation, you can just mention all the details. So user should be administrator. Creator. And then pass, it means password will be managed. And then save. Now try to run it. String 1 you can mention as a web, and here you mention as a methods. Okay, then click on OK. After that you can see the result. Okay, 200, okay, it means this is a success response. So in your, like, if you facing any kind of input signature error, so it might be you mention the input and output details wrongly, that's why you facing such a kind of a thing. Again, like once you done with your service and you like you have postman collection, you just try to API testing, like click on postman, here you can select all those things, and like wherever data you mention, like at the first time you use a web method, at a second time if you mentioning the same thing, now that case also you facing some problem. Okay, so change the data at testing time, otherwise you can check the proper data with your project team and then you can test the particular service. Okay, so guys, that's all about today's demonstration. I hope you like and enjoy this session. Okay, so if you like this session, then don't forget to subscribe, like, share and comment. Okay, and we'll come up with a new session. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Have a fun.